إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله وخير الحديث هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Tuesday next week will be the year 1440, 1440 years from the Hijra of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Hijra of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam resembles one part of the seerah, that is the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Aisha, the wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was asked, describe the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his behavior, she said, كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. His behavior is Quran. Therefore, Allah Almighty has commanded us to do as what the Prophet Muhammad said you should do, and not to do what the Prophet Muhammad told us not to do. The action and the movement of the Prophet Muhammad is something that affected a lot of people in the community that he lived in. And the biggest task of the Prophet Muhammad is to set the standard and him as a role model to the Muslims around him. People do not change by just listening. People get affected by seeing. And when Aisha radiallahu anha said that the Prophet Muhammad is Quran, is a moving Quran, Quran becomes the behavior of a human being, where he moves, where he acts, how he speaks, how he deals with people, how he walks, how he talks, it is Quran in action. And the same thing, all of the prophets throughout the history of mankind, they resembled the books that they carried in their character as where they lived. When we talk about the Hijrah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I think everyone has a brief idea about the journey of the Prophet from Mecca to Medina. Yet, where is the thing that you should focus on? How can you take advantage of this occasion to learn lessons to change your life? How can you read about the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad and take out lessons to apply these principles in yourself, to be a reflection of the character of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ? The same chemistry that happened between the Quran and the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ should be between you and the Quran, the same chemistry. Two lessons, two points I will share with you, and it will give you a feeling. So when you read about the life of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, how you can transfer these lessons in your own life. The first example, when the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ decided to migrate from Mecca to Medina, he took all the necessary precautions and causes and means to safeguard his journey to be a success. What he did was the following. He hired a man to be on the lookout and gives him all the news that took place during the hiding of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So on a daily basis he knew what was going on and who was doing what. Second thing, he hired a man to cover all of his footsteps and the sand in the desert so he would not be followed by the enemies of Islam. The third thing, he put Ali bin Abi Talib in his bed, which resembled him sleeping in his bed, where the kuffar did not know that it was not the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The fourth thing, the route that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam took to Medina was not the normal journey that all the caravans took to Medina. It was a coastal way through the coast near the sea all the way to Medina, which is not popular. Fifth point, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam stayed in hiding in Ghar Thor 3 days because the manhunt was extreme in the beginning. So one of the things he did is that he hid with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq for 3 days in that place till things cooled down. The fifth or sixth is that he hired a guide that is an expert in the streets or the ways in the desert in order to reach Medina, and that guide is someone that he trusts. Someone who's trustworthy, who can lead him to reach Medina without being exposed to the enemies of Islam. Therefore, all of these principles, the Prophet Muhammad, the precautions, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had taken in order to safeguard his journey to Medina. And you remember very well, there was a time where the kuffar were very close to the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, where they were hiding. Where in the words of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he said to the Prophet Muhammad, if one of them looks under his feet, he can see us. At that moment, the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ did all the necessary measures possible. And he said to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, we are two, and the third one with us is Allah Almighty. You notice here, everything that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam took all of these precautions is one thing, he done his homework. The rest, he submitted himself to Allah Almighty after finishing all what is required on him. And yet, he did not look back at the proper measures that he had done. He finished it, never looked back, he looked at Allah Almighty to save him from being exposed to the kuffar. What do you learn from this incident? What you and I learn is that you and me, in our daily life, in our business, in our work, in our school, in our, if you have a manufacturing plant, or if you are a farmer, or if you're a doctor, or if you're a lawyer, or in your marriage, or in your family, or in the weddings, or in funerals, all of such things, you take the proper measures that are required from you as per the principles of Islam. And then you rely on Allah Almighty after you do all of the homework necessary. It's as if nothing that you have done except you wish the support of Allah Almighty. This is lesson one. Lesson two, and the final one, is Islam is dynamic, not static. Don't be deceived that you think by sitting at home, watching a television show about Islam, or architecture, or history, or a famous lecture, and then you start feeling the good feeling about that lecture, and how important it is, and how helpful, or how much you've learned of it, and then, nothing. Good feeling that translates to nothing. Islam is dynamic, it's not static. What did you do? Ask yourself. I've heard the lecture. I saw a program about Islam. I listened to a favorite sheikh. What did I do next? What is my contribution towards Muslims? Did I act? Did I move? Did I give? Did I prevent? Did I become angry? Did I become sad? Did I become happy? Did I contact? Did I disconnect myself somebody? Where was your money? Did I spend money for that cause? Did I spend time for that cause? Did I spend effort for that thing? Did I use my physical energy to help after I heard that thing? Where is the reaction that took place from that sense and feeling? Islam is action. Islam is not static. And remember, Allah Almighty in the Quran said, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. And whoever would hope for the meeting of Allah, let him put three lines under his word. Do righteous work. Do means action. And the other verse in the Quran, and plenty of verses, only two I will expose to you. وَقُلْ اَعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَى اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And say, do as you will, for Allah will see your deeds and His Messenger and the believers. Brothers and sisters, there is no value for faith, and your faith is questionable. If it does not lead you to action. Let me give you an example. A person has skin disease. The doctor prescribed for him, in order to cure himself, he has to expose his body to the sun certain hours or certain minutes on a daily basis. That person decides to sit in a dark room, and he starts talking about how important it is for the sun to cure him from his ailment, and how many hours is required for him to be in the sun, and how the benefits of the rays of the sun can do the curing for his skin. He sits and talks and talks and talks while he is in that dark room, did not even bother himself to go outside. This is an example of the reality when faith becomes a theory rather than practice. The migration of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, Hijra, is action. Your religion, deen, is action. Your faith is action. Your Islam is action. And with action, the blessings of Allah imposes upon you. Otherwise, theoretical pleasure, philosophical thinking, emotional feelings, without action, without sacrifice, without contribution, without responsibility, put a big question mark on your faith and your iman. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, faith leads towards action. A Muslim that is not active, your faith is questionable. Brothers and sisters, we live at a day and age of total chaos and confusion, mass murders, killing, brutal killings. People are being, you can see and hear and watch on a daily basis. It's a time of confusion. You don't know who killed who is right, who is wrong, who is the evil, who is the good, who is the murderer, who is the victim, who is the police, who is the thief. We are today at an age people are selling and giving away their religion for the sake of money or the sake of a position. We are today in a day and age where women are exploited to become like a piece of merchandise and men are worshipping women. We are at a day and age where people don't know about their source of income, whether it is halal or whether it is haram. But mind you, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has narrated in the hadith عن معقل بن يسار أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said العبادة في الهرج كهجرة إليه. Staying fast and steady in worshipping Allah during the times of mass confusion, your reward is a reward of someone who migrated with the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. You and I are responsible for the following. Each one of us has to evaluate himself, evaluate his lifestyle at home, evaluate his lifestyle at work, evaluate his source of income, evaluate where his income is being spent, and make sure is your movement and your action as based per the principles of Allah and Islam, or what you carry in your tongue is different than your actions. You and I have to take it upon ourselves is to communicate with our family members, show them what is right, what is wrong, teach them what you learned, what you and I have learned, and propagate this message to people around us, whether at home or at the office or in the masjid. Discipline our children to become truthful Muslims. Make sure that our income is halal, not haram. We have to self-discipline ourselves to the commands of Allah Almighty. We have, you and me, have to dedicate on daily basis, no matter how short the time is, to educate ourselves about our Islam and learn about it and try to teach whoever is around us what we have learned during that day. You and I have to hold ourselves patient towards wrongful desires and to hold ourselves with patience towards obeying Allah Almighty. And I remind you finally as I finish this khutbah in Surah Al-Asr, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Indeed, that's the translation of it. Indeed, mankind is at a loss. At a loss because the clock is counting towards your death, so you're losing on a daily basis. Except for those who have believed and done righteous deeds and advised each other to the truth and advised each other to patience. I ask Allah Almighty, in what I've said is reflected upon me first and you also, and our family and loved ones. And I ask Allah Almighty, inshallah, in the year 1440, The bloodshed among Muslim territories and countries will stop. And Allah guide us to find Muslim leaders can lead the world to a better life for Muslims worldwide, Muslims and non-Muslims. Because when Muslims become an example, everybody else will follow Islam without even propagating the message of Islam. And I ask Allah Almighty to bless us, our families and children, to be truthful to Allah Almighty. Allahumma fi al-mu'minin wal-mu'minat, al-muslimin wal-muslimat, al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat, innaka sami'un mujibu al-da'awat. Allahumma aslih lana dinana alladhi huwa asmatu amrina, wa aslih lana dunyana allati fiha ma'ashuna, wa aslih lana akhiratuna allati ilayha ma'aduna, wa ja'al al-hayata ziyadatan fi kulli khayr, wa ja'al al-mawta rahatan lana min kulli shar. Allahumma nas'aluka al-huda wal-tuqa wal-afafa wal-ghina. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وبفضلك عما سواك اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقم الصلاة